Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. And you're probably wondering, why am I on top of this tent? Well, up here is actually... No, we're gonna ignore those boots for now. But up here is actually a Jinjo. He's just chilling up here, and we... Ooh, missed him. Okay, there we got him that time. And I wanted to show this off now because it's a pain in the ass to get on top of the tent. Basically, you have to do a talent try on one of the ropes that's connected to the bottom. And it took me a while, so I just cut out that frustration. But anyway, yes, like I said in the last part, we'll be heading out to the space world, or space zone in this section of this world, in this part, and, before we do so, we're actually gonna head back to, the crazy castle area in the Wild West zone, and, transforming with the help of Wumba, because the transformation Wumba gives us in this world actually, not only breaks up those guys, but it pays some, tolls that we have to pay to ride onto the traction, so... Yeah, there's no free rides in this world. We actually have to pay our way onto them. And, let's see, right here, let's just make our way across, and... I know you're there. Okay, god, that was close. Okay. Those things, they come out when they want to. They're not really the friendliest of fellows. And, just so you know, I actually lowered the game volume slightly in this part because people said that the game volume was a little too loud, so I listened and lowered it a bit, so... We'll see how it comes out, I guess, and there is a nice little warp head, and... Let's go inside the wigwam. It's a little bigger than normal. And wow, okay, this globo is pretty obvious to get. Real challenging right there. They usually spread them out much further in the game as the game progresses. And you have globo want to give to Wumba. Yes. Wumba, it's Humba, not Wumba. Okay. Sorry there. Confusing my Indian names. Alright, we know the Jingo and we know the Lingo. Let's just jump in the pool. Okay. So we have a dynamite, we have a stony. What we got this time? Whoa, it's a van. Awesome. Got like a little money sign. It's like the things that they take to the banks. Wumba called this van. Van carries much coins. Use left stick to move and X for horn. Okay. Basically, we have to like get to control this little jalopy. Basically, if you hit X next to these van sign doors, they take us to different areas and they have different stuff inside of them. So that's pretty cool. And that just took us easier down. And oh god, I'm so oh god, we're murderers! Hooray! I love a little jingle. You got a ticket for the Congo's Big Top. Alright, so there is a method to this madness of genocide against these slot machines. They have tickets inside of them, and basically we need their tickets to gain entry into the Big Top, which I'll be probably saving until the end, because I like to keep the boss of the area until the last part. I think that pretty much builds it up and whatnot. And I think it's a better idea. And let's see right here, and look at his ticket. So that's four tickets. I believe there is only four, or is there five? Okay, there's five. Gotta destroy you two. Oh wait, no, we already killed this guy. Okay, there's four tickets, I guess, or maybe there is five, I'm not sure. Just know, I think they have five, what, five's kind of a round number, so I think that would be pretty obvious. But, yeah, with the van, we actually could do a few things. Let's actually just go to Area 51 right now, because they actually, oh, whoa, we got it. She really couldn't find the kid that's right there in front of her. polar bear parenting, I swear, sometimes. I guess we'll be helping that kid out in whatever way we can. Oh wow, we're almost done with the oranges, cool. We need Mumbo to power up that. Like I said before, Mumbo is basically the mechanic of this world. And we'll be seeing how useful he can be later on in this part. But for now, we're just gonna hop around and jump around in our van. This thing is so powerful, it just trucks everything. And the horn's just there for show, I guess. And it opens up the door, so it's not that useless. And anyway, yes, we have to actually go in there with the van, but we don't have Mumbo to open that up yet, so... Oh well, and yeah, there's actually something over here, that's why I came over here. There is a treble clef. Treble note thing, okay, so that's 330 notes, awesome. I think we have all the notes in this world, if not, actually there was a few by the entrance, so we don't have them all just yet, but this is where we have to take the van, and I actually thought this was open the first time. In the beginning of this part, I was actually gonna start off with Mumbo, but... Forgot that we have to pay here. Oh well. Pay here to enter the fearsome furnace of the inferno. Let's just poop out some coins. There we go. A silver coin. A JFK, I guess. The ride is now open. There we go. The inferno. Oh man, that sounds like a badass ride right there. I want to go inside that. It looks more like an area than a ride, but I love how that, like, its mouth is like the stone thing. It actually can hurt you if you jump on it, I think, on the wrong spot, so. Just a fun fact. And speaking of fun facts, this world is actually, like, the first three worlds in this game, it's funny because they were all supposed to be in the first game. I guess they had so many ideas in the first game that they just wanted to, like, I don't know, they had a lot of options to get for worlds, and I guess these three were the most, like, graphically demanding, so they put them off until this game, which I think was a good idea. Obviously, there are three great worlds. I like this one a lot, that's for sure. And so we're done with the van for now. Unfortunately, with the van, you can't do everything at once. I like to always do that, but we have to now get Mumbo, and he'll, what the? You just see Banjo on that? He was, like, levitating on his back. Oh, my God. That was actually, like, a little freaky right there. Ugh. That was a little scary. It's like a creepypasta that can originate from that. But anyway, let's take this warp head onto, I guess behind the Big Ten. Yeah, I think it's the closest to the Inferno. Because Mumbo is in the Inferno, that is why I opened it up right now, because we want to get all Mumbo's stuff done fast. But let's do the Dive of Death first. That sounds really fun. I really want to do that. I know it sounds deadly, but hey, YOLO. Okay, don't say YOLO. Don't say it even sarcastically. Oh, there's a Jiggy up there. Awesome. Wouldn't they put the Jiggy in the diving pool? Like, why don't I even have to jump in? But hey, we'll jump in anyway. We're afraid of nothing. I laugh in the face of danger, and hopefully he'll grab on. No! Banjo! Banjo! Okay, I almost died. I was hoping he would grab. Okay, yeah. Dude, why did I say mood? I'm in a bad mood right now because I just missed that jump. I was hoping he would do a grip grab onto that ledge because it's kind of hard to just walk on it. Alright, enough whispering. Let's just. I guess we'll walk it. I guess we'll free walk it. Okay, yeah. If you got a nice straight. Oh, God! Okay. We're okay. We're all still here. We're all still here. And let's just get this Jiggy. And let's get our perspective right. And hopefully I make the dive. There he goes. And it's a perfect 10, but a score from 9 with the Russians or Germans. I don't know. Is it the Germans or the Russians? I'm not sure. It's one of the bad guys back from back in the day. I'm guessing it's the Russians. Who knows? But yeah, we got the two note little bins right there. And now that we failed in doing that, and safely recovering, let's get this nice little honeycomb piece. There we go. We can go inside of the Inferno. We're going to save off those two green and purple areas until later. I think in the next part or two, depending on how long this world will take. I think this world's probably going to be 4. Oh, I should have went in the van. Ah, I think it has a Cheeto page. Oh, well, we'll have to be getting the van anyway. So, what are you going to do? Oh, well. I try to plan the best in this playthrough. Like, I'm really proud of myself right now. Like, in this playthrough, I'm actually planning stuff pretty well, I think. I've been writing out, like, little bullet notes of what to get first and whatnot. And, oh, okay, we have to get the Globo first. And right now we're going according to schedule. And I think the Globo is actually over here. Oh God. Thank God Banjo doesn't incinerate like most things would in magma. Oh God, it's the henchman, he's guarding it. And Franken Mallet's dead, okay. All right, so let's get you Globo. At least they hide it a little better than Wumba. Is it Mumba or Wumba? I don't know, the Indian lady. I'm not trying to be racist or anything, but the woman who transforms us into different objects. Who isn't Mumbo? All right, so let's just give Mumbo this Globo, and hopefully he'll do some nice magical mechanical work in this world. All right, so we cuts the gist, Mumbo. We got a Globo. You're gonna help us. We don't need to. We have to skip the formalities right here. And yes, okay. Wouldn't they notice that they're in the same like dialogue loop every single time? Be like, wow, we're getting really bad deja vu here. And there we go. He tightens up his belt and brings out his magic stick, and he is good to go. All right, Mumbo. You got a lot of work to do in this part. You gotta activate 3 rides. So hope you have it in ya. And let's see, I think there's a warp head I hit over here. That's actually pretty nifty. It's gonna make getting around much easier. There we go. Now I activated it. And let's go to the space zone first. I think we have to go to Area 51 and the 2 space zone rides. So let's just do the space spinner, I think this ride's called, first. And this is actually one of the easier jiggies to get, the star spinner, sorry, to get in space world. There's 3 jiggies, I believe, in the space section. So this is probably one of the most, most jiggies, I guess you would say, in the zone. And there we go, we got Power, the Star Spinner. So Power is basically his magical spell in this, and basically he says jumpstart all the rides. For free, no less. I guess for a Globo, that's his commission. Imagine if every freaking piece of art just had Mumbo Because I know I always go to an amusement park, there's always a ride that's broken in every amusement park I ever go to. It just sucks. I remember I actually went to Disney this past, like, May, and the freaking Splash Mountain was under construction. I went to the one in Florida, and I was like, oh, that's my favorite ride. Now, like, I only can do two rides. Like, basically, Splash Mountain, Space Mountain, and Western Roller Coaster are only ones I can ride, because that's, like, the only adult rides, I guess you would say. So it's a major bummer. What the? Okay, I got one of the kids in here. So we have to remember, one of the kids is by Area 51. One of the kids is in here. And we're still missing another one, so we'll have to keep an eye out on him. But we'll probably not even be getting them back yet to the mom yet, because we actually have to get them... Or one of the polar bears is actually, you have to know another move to get him out to his mom, so we'll probably be ignoring them until we learn that move. And I hope this works. All right, so two right next to each other. Let's activate the Dodge-em Dope. This, I believe, is similar to the kickball tournament in that kind of style. 3-on-1, 2-on-1, 1-on-1, and whatnot. So that'll be fun. But this time we can do it as Banjo and Kazooie. I believe it's like a not dodgeball. It's like a bumper car kind of thing. So it should be fun. And there we go. It is now activated. But in order to gain access to that area, we'll be needing to come back with the van. That's why I said before that it was a bummer that that wasn't open while I had the van. And let's see, we're done here. Let's go to the old entry, I believe. I think we have to go to Area 51, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I think we have to go to the left side. And I think that's done. That's it, we're with Mumbo. So once we activate this Mumbo pad, we're good to go. So yes, always a good idea to get all of Mumbo's stuff done in the beginning of the world, like I said before. And this is actually going to activate the Saucer of Peril. Okay, technically this isn't a space zone, Jiggy, but I count it as space, because you know that that box of aliens we rescued in Glitter Gulch Mine? Well, this is going to activate that attraction. But I remember I always thought, I don't know, for some reason, in Glitter Gulch Mine I got confused and thought I can activate that right away, but... No, we activated the runway for Area 51, making that ride accessible to that Saucer of Peril. This is actually, I'm going to say it right now, this is probably my favorite minigame in the entire game. And probably be seeing that in the next part, though, because we're already at 12 minutes here, and we'll probably be only doing, like, one or two Jiggies in the space world. Want to keep these parts nice and fresh, nice in the 15-minute mark. We got to come back for those notes as well. I believe there's a shock pad over there. And I can't... Worst mother ever! And she's got jingling boobies to top it off. What kind of decency do you have, woman? But yes, let's see, let's go back to Mumbo's skull. We're done with you. Good job, Mumbo. You got like 5 minutes of screen time. And that's about what you have in each of the worlds we'll be seeing. Alright, so let's put him back on his little high chair pedestal, whatever. And get Banjo and Kazooie and do a Jiggy in the Inferno, because there is actually one in here. It's not just a fiery area of nothingness. And, okay, I went right into that. Whoops. And he still has that bleh grunt like all the other ones have. That must have been, like, the best voice acting job ever. Just, okay.
Just go into the mic and say, bleh! Okay.
Okay, I'm really curious how that came out in the video. Oh, God, that probably came out terrible. I'm so sorry, everyone. But anyway, let's switch up with Banjo and Kazooie. Alright, oregano, that's what I think they say. That's basically what they do say. Oh, we have to get Banjo first. Yeah, about that. And let's do his little jump right here that we cheated with. And step on the shock pad, switch with Banjo. Yeah, teamwork right here. And up on top of the Inferno will be a jump pad, switch or shock pad, which will be activated right there. And we'll be needing Kazooie to run up there with the running shoes, because I believe... Oh, whoopsie daisy. Okay, I hit A instead of B to switch. Alright, he's on the switch, good. And Kazooie only has 3 health bars, which sucks, because look at that. Now we got 2, so we gotta be very careful. Okay, we gotta be very careful here. Careful here. Or even much careful. And jump. So you can't just run up all willy-nilly. You gotta actually, like, stop and go, stop and go. Red light, green light! Okay. That was close. And we don't have a time limit, so I can really take all the time I want. And I don't think the running shoes, What? Are you, really? Okay. Take 2, I guess. Oh, man, that was really unfortunate. What the hell, man? Alright, we're just about to the top, and I just got hit, but we have 3 more health bars left, so we should be good. How don't know how I got hit on that last one. He, like, barely nicked me. I don't know. Oh, okay, the running shoes do run out. Okay. Don't heed my, instruction in the beginning. Go back 2 minutes in the video. And there we go, we got a Jiggy, and we can just die with Kazooie. Doesn't really matter. And, okay. Okay, good. Now you die, Kazooie. You were gonna die in this part anyway, but you died twice instead. I'm sorry. You're still my friend, right? Okay, we're not friends, okay. Let's just leave the Inferno now and head out to the Space Zone. Do we want to actually... I don't know why I didn't take the warp head back there. Oh, well, I guess we'll walk it. Enjoy the sights. I like those little flashing lights on the tent right there. And, yeah, the Space Zone's not that far away. Oh, well. Yeah, let's go in the tent. You know what? While we're on the way, let's just see if we can get that cheat. I doubt it, but let's see what we got. What's our fate? You win some red feathers. Wow, she's really in a generous mood this time around. And then now she's closed. Because last time, I was just getting the crap beaten out of me in that. But I guess she's in a happier mood, and she'll take pity on us. So I thought I was going to be able to get more of the Space Zone done in this part, but I guess we'll just get one of them done. I don't know. We'll do the bumper car one and the sorcerer one in the next part, I guess. Oh, well. We got a lot of stuff, a lot of barriers knocked over and whatnot, so we got a lot accomplished. It may have seemed like not a lot. Like, I was trying to go for 5 Jiggies in this part. That was a very big goal I set, but I think we only got, like, 2 or 3 Jiggies. Oh, well. Still a lot. Still decent, right? All right, so now that we've got now, we can just fall down. I don't want to die. Okay. I don't want to jump on that, too. And there we go. That's how you take no fall damage, which I want to get that cheat, by the way. That's going to be a great cheat. I definitely want to get some more Cheeto pages to get that cheat, because that's one of them, by the way. There we go. We got some health, and yes, I think that will end it here. So thank you guys for watching. In the next part, we will be transforming back to the van momentarily to gain access to the bumper cars, and after we're done with that, we'll be doing that sorcerer ride, and hopefully, I think exploring more of the Inferno section and whatnot. So I'll see you later, guys, and until next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. See you later.